Anyone else? Lecture Tuesday, The Indian and the Star, a fable. Bears, lions, and elk, the greatest warriors. A Machiavellian plan, the truth must out. There is something about brothers. If Coach had suggested I try to be like anyone else, whether Trong, Yost, Keen, even Squid, if he hadn't said my model should have been Hider, things would have been different. That's not to say they would have played out for the best. I believe what happened was for the best, ultimately, but that doesn't mean it was easy. In fact, it couldn't have been much harder, but hard is good. Hard is what makes us who we are. All I'm saying is that it wouldn't have happened the way it did if Coach hadn't compared me to Hider. He meant it as a compliment and a challenge, in the best sense of a challenge, I can see that now, but there's just something about brothers. It was Tuesday, Coach was in form. His subject, the power of setting goals. He spoke that day in metaphors and fables. He spoke of bows and arrows and stars in the night sky, and a young Indian trying to be great. It was hard to follow, actually. I think he made it up on the spot. "An Indian boy," he said as he sauntered back and forth in front of his blackboard, the word goals written large enough to fill it, "wanted to impress his village. He knew that the greatest warriors showed their greatness by bringing down the greatest prey, grizzly bears, lions, elk." Hider's hand went up. You'd think Coach would have stopped calling on him after the loins lecture, but he didn't. "Champ," he said impatiently, "what you want now?" "That sounds really great and all." Hider grinned and glanced around, waiting for approval. Nobody got it, so he hurried on. "And I'm very interested in where this is all leading us, but those animals don't live together, not in the same environment, I mean." "God damn it," sighed Yost, his knee bobbing spastically. "You're an idiot. Just let him finish so we can go run." "They don't," said Hider, a little offended. "How can the Indians in the village in this particular story kill those three animals? There are no bears or elk in Africa, and Africa is the only place lions live, unless he means mountain lions. Cougars." His face turned pensive. "Actually, there are some lions in Asia, too. Not mountain lions, but real lions. But there aren't any elk or bears there. At least not grizzlies. Those live only in North America. Elk, too. Actually, it could work if..." "Shut the hell up," interrupted Victor. "Fine," said Hider, his hands palm up in submission, as if he recognized, for once, his tendency to ramble. "I'll shut up." "Okay, then," said Coach to Hider. "And you," he pointed at Victor, "watch your mouth." "Look who's suddenly all holier than thou," said Victor. "Captain curse a lot. I'll watch my mouth when you start watching yours." "Shut up," said Coach, "and let me get on with this so we're not here till tomorrow. Anyways, this Indian boy, he knew the greatest warriors killed the greatest animals." He glanced at Hider. "Whatever the hell those animals were for where he lived. Is that satisfactory, K2? Hider nodded. "And he wanted to outdo everyone who ever killed an animal before him because he wanted to be the greatest Indian of all time. So the Indian boy knew he'd have to do something pretty special. One night, he looks up in the sky and sees the stars. He's there with his dad or something. And he says, 'Has any Indian ever killed a star?'" Coach paused, not to see if Hider wanted to comment, but for dramatic effect. He raised his eyebrows and put his finger up in the air as if to say, "This is getting good." He went on. "No," says the dad. "No Indian has ever killed a star. It's impossible," says the dad. "Impossible." And that's where things went weird. There was something about the boy shooting his arrow all night and all day up in the air. "And it would come down," said Coach, making a big deal of looking down on the locker room floor as if staring at the Indian boy's arrow. "And the boy would shoot it back up, making a big deal of pointing up at the ceiling. In the end, the boy shot himself with his own arrow, I think. Or maybe he just died of old age. But he never stopped shooting that arrow. In any case, it didn't really work out for the boy. Coach seemed pleased, though. K1, he said as we restlessly waited down in that dingy locker room for the moral of the story so we could go do our workout. You'll be a state champ one day if you can focus like that Indian boy. And at this, I was no longer so anxious to get out of there. I was flattered, in fact, as long as Coach kept saying my name and speculating on how great I was going to be. We could stay down there forever, as far as I was concerned. By that point in the season, my hatred for Coach had been eroding, as the troubles he had had a hand in creating for me, Slade, my brother, the first day of school, evolved or softened with time. The chronic soreness in my legs was fading. As I approached 40 miles a week, subtle changes were happening to my body. The veins in my arms seemed more prominent, the individual muscles in my thighs more defined. I liked the changes Coach had wrought in me. Had he not gone on and compared me unfavorably to my brother, I believe things would have been different. But he did. "You and Keene, you'll all three be state champs," he said, "if you can just focus like your brother." He smiled after he said it. He meant no dishonor. But I was back, and the time it took to utter that one benign little sentence to being his constant victim, at least in my screwed-up head. During the run that day, I formed a Machiavellian plan that scares me now when I realize that I, as a 14-year-old, was capable of conceiving it. It was very simple. I realized, as I silently jogged next to my brother and Keene, half hearing them laugh about the Indian boy and his arrow, Coach was too messed up to defend himself. I didn't need evidence. I didn't need the truth. The man was a lunatic. I just needed to get him in the same room with the school principal for 5 minutes, keep my own mouth shut, and provide him the opportunity to destroy himself. My story wouldn't even matter.